we're doing here is unsnapping the top piece that keeps the frame in. You can just use your fingers at this stage. You don't have to use a screwdriver or anything else, and it comes off. It's just a little bit of cocaine. It is recommended to be gentle though, as you don't want to try to break anything.
Mounting with a little bit of sticky glue type tape stuff. I'll leave a couple of pegs back there. So you remove them from the back plate, and now they're just hanging off the back of the screen here. I was supposed to remove the battery at the start. One thing that wasn't clear to me in the other videos was exactly how this connection here is made. First, the connection actually comes up from the bottom and slides in like that. So if you take this top piece of tape off, then that should give you the right direction to slowly disconnect that thing. Again, gently remove the tape. Yours may not come off. Thank you.
matter of putting in the last screws and screwing them in. And there's a little metal frame that you put the screen on that screws into that framework.
Yeah, so right now the screen is in the still somewhat. I'm going to apply a little bit of pressure just to replace the screws.
Again, these are the four short ones that you're putting in first. They attach directly to the new screen.
So now that we've got our port screen back installed, this moves just like the chip. All you should need is a screwdriver. I forgot to remove the screen protector before I screwed it all back on. You take it all back off to do it properly, or press in there, so you just take it out of the way. Probably some kind of power activation.
rotate it around just a little bit.
Yep, it's all good.